Hi, good afternoon. I am Laura Montanaro of Polytechnic of Torino. And first, I would like to thank the organizers of this kind invitation and the opportunity they gave me to present you this talk. I wish also to thank the European Ceramic Society for the valuable support in collecting data needed to outline some key features of higher education on ceramics in Europe. The outline of this presentation is here shown. After an introduction to present you the context of this talk, I will briefly discuss the results of a survey concerning the higher education on ceramics in Europe, introducing also some new educational opportunities arising from 3D printing and additive manufacturing technologies. Particularly, I will focus my discussion on the knowledge transfer to the designers and artisans, which represent a European cultural and economic resource to involve in this transition, always searching a balance between immaterial and material, or also between virtual and real, by using the words of the French philosopher Pierre Lévy. In the final part, I will briefly introduce the objectives and the experimental approach of an ongoing research we are performing in a multidisciplinary team to find the good blend between artisan human creativity and digitalization, material culture and immaterial tools. The dematerialization as well the digitalization of industry and design processes are promoting the need of an increasingly complex and updated education of the young people, more and more involved in experiencing and designing the digital matter. New processing models and new professional profiles must be defined through sustainable development model, preserving a human-centered point of view. Therefore, starting from a quick overview of the higher education on ceramics in Europe, some examples of these new educational opportunities are presented. A broad analysis of the higher education on ceramics in Europe has been recently launched by ESERS, and some preliminary comments on the data collected from several, both comprehensive and technical European universities are here drawn out. For the sake of brevity, just a list of the European universities up to now included in this analysis and the related countries is provided in the next slides. Austria, Belgium, Croatia, Czech Republic, Denmark, Finland, France, Hungary, Italy, Poland, Romania, Russia, Slovenia, Slovakia, Spain, and finally Sweden, Switzerland, the Netherlands, and UK. Even if this directory cannot be yet considered complete, some interesting results can be drawn out and commented. First, there is a large offer of courses focused on ceramics spread all over Europe, but very few educational paths are totally focused on ceramics material. In fact, courses on ceramic materials at bachelor and or masters of science level are offered in the frame of educational path devoted to materials as a whole. For instance, educational path devoted to material science, or material science and technology, materials engineering, advanced materials, materials and nanoscience, nanotechnology, and so on. These courses are mainly aimed at supplying technical scientific fundamentals, basic and/or applied advanced knowledge and competencies in science and technology of traditional as well as innovative ceramics. Some common contents are devoted to discuss, for instance, topics related to basic science, like crystal structures and defects, phase diagrams, solid state diffusion mechanisms, and so on. Synthesis and processing of ceramics, their conventional forming and firing, bulk and surface properties of ceramic components, several characterization techniques at room and at high temperature, different types of ceramic materials, including dense and porous, as well as transparent ceramics, glasses, cements and concretes, abrasives, refractories, and so on, for several industrial, traditional, and advanced applications. For instance, in aerospace, energy, nuclear, microelectronics, biomedical, and environmental fields. Several courses include also workshops and laboratory activities to foster not only theoretical competencies, but also practical skills. In some countries, ceramic manufacturing and design are also taught within educational programs at bachelor or MS level in archaeology, archaeometry, conservation and restoration of cultural heritage. For instance, in this context, the Staffordshire University in UK offers a ceramics-focused degree program, but it is a design-based course that is artistic rather than science engineering oriented. In few universities, 3D printing, additive manufacturing, processing of ceramics are discussed, mostly as one of the topics approached in courses devoted to provide a more spread knowledge on these technologies and to deepen their applications to all the materials categories, but particularly to metals, polymers, and their composites. Or they are discussed in courses for PhD students, candidates. In very few cases, courses fully devoted to theoretical aspects, as well as training activities in laboratory on additive manufacturing of ceramics are now offered. In these courses, as in the case of the Engineering School of Limoges, France, purely cited by way of example, 3D printing of ceramics is discussed and compared to the traditional forming methods, also underlining the specific differences in terms of raw materials, process parameters, and degrees of freedom in design. However, more and more, there are new educational opportunities arising from the 3D printing AM revolution. These opportunities are due to the innovative features of the components produced by using these techniques and to the unique flexibility in their design. This new knowledge could powerfully contribute to the training of new professional profiles, as well as to create new market opportunities. ESRS is very active in this sense. Particularly, I would like to mention the Young Ceramists Network, an initiative of ESRS supported by JACS Trust. It is an interdisciplinary platform fully run by a committee of young researchers. This independent network is mainly aimed at promoting the sharing of ideas and opportunities in a wide community of young ceramists. They have recently cooperated to organize an interactive conference devoted to additive manufacturing of ceramics held at the end of October of this year, just a few days ago. These initiatives has been promoted by EMC, Europe Makes Ceramics, a network founded in 2015 by ESRS to bring together scientists working in the field of additive manufacturing of ceramic materials. The program of this online forum is here shown. Several topics are approached, such as robocasting, stereolithography, selective laser sintering, melting, and so on. These new opportunities do not concern only academia or large companies. For instance, also ceramic designers and artisans represent a relevant added value, as also witnessed by the cultural route supported by the European Council, named European Route of Ceramics. This route is aimed to make the European ceramics heritage more accessible to European citizens by promoting a dynamic image of this heritage, both physical, with objects used in several sectors, such as culinary activities, the art, medicine, architecture, and so on, and intangible, including the know-how and crafts necessary for its production. A first example of activities developed to combine tradition and innovation in a synergic way is the Erasmus Plus project named Cerasmus Plus, Ceramics European Project for Networking, Heritage and Innovation. Erasmus Plus is a European program to support education, training, youth, and sport in Europe. This project, Cerasmus Plus, was carried out in the period of 2017-19, and it involved 8 partners from 6 European countries, namely Spain, Italy, Finland, Czech Republic, Hungary, and Poland. This project has established several objectives precisely to harmonize tradition and innovation, to protect the European traditional heritage, and to modernize the ceramic sector. This project has pursued the above objectives through 3 main actions, precisely the creation of a European network of ceramics stakeholders for analyzing the sector needs for competencies with reference to the improvement of value chain, valorization of urban environment, and business startups. The second is the harmonization of ceramic traditions with innovative design and production techniques. And finally, the revision and innovation of vocational education and ceramic sector through work-based learning models in order to strengthen the sector value at cultural, social, and economic level. In the frame of this project, several training activities were designed and delivered, aimed at improving the ceramic craft sector value chain with reference to the production techniques which are able to keep together tradition and innovation, like 3D printing, as clearly witnessed by the content of one of these training programs. The second example we have selected deals with an Interreg project, CERD. Interreg Europe supports projects and offers opportunities for regional and local stakeholders across Europe to share ideas and experience for improving strategies for their communities. This project, CERD, started in May 2019, will last till to the end of June 2022. And it involves 8 partners from 6 European countries, precisely Czechia, Italy, Germany, Poland, Austria, and Slovenia. This project, CERD, is aimed at pursuing many important objectives thanks to the establishment of a network of several stakeholders and a platform to support creative ceramists. It is mainly aimed at preserving and expanding the European potential in creative ceramics, also opening new perspectives thanks to the innovative processing technologies. To this end, the platform makes accessible information, ideas, knowledge, and techniques, particularly the additive manufacturing technologies, to increase the potential of designers and artisans. Artisans and designers, but also students and individuals who are interested in shaping a future as a ceramic entrepreneur, and small and medium companies which are interested in gaining advantage in the local, European, and global market are addressed by this project. For instance, in the frame of CERD, they are now organizing a workshop to introduce artisans, but also students and SMEs to the new shaping technologies and to explore the creative and industrial potentials of digital design and innovative production methods. In April 2020, they have also organized a competition called Future Lights in Ceramics, mostly fostering young creatives, artisans, and designers to face the new technologies for producing ceramic items. Particularly, they underline the flexibility of these methods, the possibility to choose among the production of unique pieces or a small series, or even mass production, as well as the possibility to do just a slight change in programming to reach a uniqueness in a multiplicity. The last part of this talk is aimed at introducing you our research project entitled The Digitalization of Matter, Rethinking, Communicating, and Transmitting Materiality in the Virtual Era. We are studying the implication of the increasing digital transition on the production of ceramics. focusing attention on the new relationship established between immaterial and material, digital and real, within the ceramic production process, from design to production, but also to marketing and distribution. This transformation has several implications, like on the experiment research devoted to the application of digital technologies to ceramic materials, on the artisanal and industrial production. Ceramics are really paradigmatic of the new bridge needed between craftsmanship and digitalization, on the way of training the skills for managing the digital transformation. The aims of our research are here listed: to understand the innovation in the design and transformation of ceramic materials in close relation to the digitalization processes, including AM. To study artisanal and industrial ceramic practices under the strong pressure of digitalization. To figure out the impact on learning and educational processes. And finally, to increase a culture of human materiality in a world that is apparently more and more immaterial and disembodied. Just a few words now about the methodology. The research is strongly interdisciplinary. It intends to look at the digital transformation by enhancing the dialogue between two complementary fields of study: the science and technology on ceramics on one hand, and sociological studies on digital culture and the transformation of work on the other. The integration of pedagogical and communication skills will be progressively promoted during the research to increase the possible theoretical and practical implication of the project in the context of training and education. The research includes desk and field analysis. The empirical field analysis provides for interviews with professionals and the enterprises in the sector of ceramics. The target are designers, artisans, SMEs that produce high quality ceramic products. For instance, made in Italy companies characterized by high artisanal value. A key innovation is therefore the foreshadowing of new hybrid professional profiles as the result of training courses that combine traditional practices and competencies, innovative technologies, and digital skills. The research aims to bring out the possible hybridization between tradition and innovation, with the idea that digital transformation can and should be an empowerment tool for people who study and work in the domain of ceramics. For instance, allowing conception and creation of new products. And also, it allows resilience and advancement of the creative production of ceramics, not replacing traditional cultures and practices, but fostering them. That is, ensuring their transferability to new generations, as well as expanding their range of action in terms of new products and new markets. We intend to develop a human-centered approach to digitalization, and we would foster people to move from a passive to an active approach to the technology. In fact, a passive approach aims to consider exclusively the autonomous nature of the algorithmic digital machine and its ability to expel the human from the intelligence of processes. The active approach considers the digital technology not only a simple tool, but an experimental environment that allows humans to transform the machine creatively, orienting it towards their own needs and ideas. A theoretical framework for the research is the figure of the digital craftsman. The traditional craftsman works following a context-based approach, a strongly experiential approach, not very abstract and not standardized, difficult to transmit and communicate with formalized tools and languages. The digital craftsman, on the other hand, incorporates and brings together in his work both the experience of the traditional craftsman, the practice of hands and gestures that transform the materiality, and the abstraction and formalization typical of the digital tools. In the figure of the digital craftsman, body and mind, material practice and digital technologies come together. To conclude this talk, simply as an example, I would like to present you few suggestions and ideas drawn out from a long interview to Elena Salmistrao, an Italian product designer and artist. She works for leading companies in the creative industry, including Apple, Disney, Lavazza, Nike, Bosa, Timberland, and many others. I would like to draw your attention just on some claims that can synthesize her comments, giving relevant stimuli for further discussion and progress of our research. In fact, she said us that digital tools can induce a standardization of the language and of the communication, as well as the production of ceramic objects without a soul. Therefore, the designer must not become a servant of the machine, but human creativity is always to lead the design process, exploiting the potentialities of the digital tools, but also promoting their further evolution. So in conclusion, innovation in educational processes, knowledge sharing, and the related cultural growth are key points in this exciting path into the future of ceramics. Many thanks for your kind attention.